Now, from Atlanta, Georgia, this is the Game Show Temple Archives Update, January 2nd, 2022. Viewer's Choice Week and the Top 40 Countdown have both come to an end as of December 26th, but they are officially being retired. And that is the top story on the Game Show Temple Archives Update. Good afternoon and Happy New Year, I'm Michael Tiller. The last Viewer's Choice Week ended on Christmas Day, December 25th, 2021, with the share of Allweiler vs. Bussy on Family Feud, and the Top 40 Countdown the following Sunday, December 26th. Here is a screenshot of the Viewer's Choice Week ballot from Google Forms. You can see here that the $1 million chance of a lifetime Sarah and Vince versus Kim and George got the popular vote of 27 votes, while Sarah the Century got 25, Scrabble 23, and there was a tie at the 4th and 5th positions for Family Feud, Dustin versus Rutenbar, and Let's Make a Deal $10,479 big deal with 19 votes apiece. So a random drawing determined which episode played when. As for the Christmas episode, it was very tight with Allweiler vs. Bussy receiving only 13 votes, while Family Feud Challenge, Hollywood Squares, and Press Your Luck not too far behind. But the number of overall ballots received was very underwhelming. If you look at the very top of the window, you will notice that only 55 ballots were received. Compared to the last two ballots for the Top 40 Countdown and the previous Viewer's Choice Week in June of last year, the June 2021 ballot for Viewer's Choice Week had only 89 ballot submissions, but the top episode voted for only received 36 votes, or 40.4% of the popular vote. And the Top 40 Countdown, the numbers were more underwhelming than the previous Viewer's Choice Week. Only 74 ballots were received, but the top moment of the tight supermarket sweep ending received only 26 votes, or 35%. Those numbers are just not strong enough, and popularity is not very high. So therefore, both the Top Moment Countdown and Viewer's Choice Weeks are being retired. But to those who did participate in helping make the past Viewer's Choice Weeks and Top Moment Countdowns what they were, thank you for your participation in helping make them what they were. In spite of the fact that Viewer's Choice Week and the Top Moment Countdown will no longer be part of the Game Show Temple, theme weeks will still occasionally take place from time to time. There will be honoring of game show moments such as Big Wins, Show of the Week, as well as Host of the Week, and other surprises that may come along. Please be sure you stay tuned to the Game Show Temple Archives channel for more details as they come along. Our next story today does not apply to this channel directly, but rather to an episode or two shared earlier in December, one in part of Viewer's Choice Week. To be specific, this is a theory that explains how I personally feel that a contestant was invited back from a previous show. Patty Gerardo was a contestant on Sail the Century, air dates in November 1988, and she was eventually invited back. Although it was not directly stipulated as to what her disadvantage was, I do have a personal hunch on what I think happened. In Patty's original episode that aired on November 17th, she was a contestant during True Romance Week. As the speed round was taking down, however, she buzzed in and responded to this question.
What French name is given to the small bouquet that you pin on your date's dress, Patty?
It's a boutonniere or a corsage.
Wrong.
Jim explained that a boutonniere is generally one flower and not a bouquet of flowers. But although she about changed her answer to corsage, which was the answer that they were looking for, if you listen again to the question, they were not specific as to what gender the date was in the question. And also researching the first answer, boutonniere is French for buttonhole flower, while corsage is also French for bouquet de corsage. But since the question didn't quite specify the kind of date and both boutonniere and corsage are French terms, that's why I believe she was invited back. Please comment if you have a different theory. But as you have seen, Patty has won in her return, and her series will continue as they get selected by the random process. We may now be in 2022, but as always, we must be respectful of the rules here at the Game Show Temple Archives, and this is in case anyone has not seen the About tab. Although we do welcome comments and feedback, we do not allow certain comments, such as those that could potentially spoil the outcome of the episode in question, no political comments, no rude behavior, no imposters, no off-topic comments, nothing personal, and no negativity, and of course, no requests or demands. Spoilers not only give away the outcome of the video, but also do hinder potential viewers. One person has said that if they see a comment that spoils the outcome of a video before they watch it, they close it. So please, do not spoil the episodes. Political comments, I respect that we have our own views on today's political platform, but it does not matter whose side you're on. It isn't fair to air your political laundry on this channel, nor is it fair to try and update previous political questions with modern-day answers. No rude behavior, nothing personal, and no negativity is self-explanatory, but one example that I can tell you is that someone hated an episode so much last year, they wanted me to take it down immediately, and even became hostile to other users who had left comments before, trying to convince them that they hated it and that they wanted it taken down. Just because you don't like an episode doesn't mean everyone else has to hate it. If you don't like it, don't watch it. It's as simple as that. No imposters. Some users have replied to other users as if they were me. I'm the only person who runs this channel. No one else does. And of course, no requests or demands. Some people have been seeking particular episodes of certain shows, and rather than ask if we have it, ask for it to be uploaded. Now, although I do not mind the occasional check-in, making requests and demands for shows are not permitted because it's no guarantee that I have it. Plus, all episodes are randomly selected and scheduled in advance to ensure variety here at the Game Show Double Archives. Please keep it clean and keep it fair in whatever comment you post. And finally today, we acknowledge the passing of a television legend. Not long after the December 23rd, 1980 episode of Password Plus was publicized on this channel on Friday, word officially broke out that Betty White had passed away. Betty White was a legend in the world of television. She was a very recognizable face to many a person for many generations. She played the role of Sue Ann Nivens on The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Elka Ostrowski on Hot in Cleveland, but one of her most prominent roles was Rose Nyland on the highly acclaimed sitcom The Golden Girls. She was nicknamed the First Lady of Game Shows, as she made appearances on so many of them, including Match Game, To Tell the Truth, Tattletales, and especially Password. She also had a brief stint of hosting Just Men in 1983, which, in spite of being canceled after just 13 weeks, won her an Emmy. She was married to Password host Alan Ludden from 1963 up until his death in 1981. Betty was just shy of celebrating her 100th birthday by only 18 days. In honor and memory of Betty's career in game shows, this channel, the Game Show Temple Archives, will hold a special tribute week for Betty by sharing 6 game show episodes that she was on, whether hosting or guest starring on, and we will be doing that the week of her birthday. But on behalf of all of her fans all around the world, our thoughts and our prayers go out to Betty's family, her friends, and all of her colleagues. That's it for the Game Show Temple Archives update. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you all are doing well. Have a great rest of your weekend, and bye for now.